In this video, I'm going to help you quickly and easily install WordPress on your Windows computer. I'm Tim from realwebsitehints.com, and I want to help you find the best and easiest techniques for making websites. So let's go ahead and get started by installing WordPress on our Windows computer.
Okay, so the first thing we need to do is download the software that we're going to use to make essentially a server on our Windows computer. So to do that, I like to use MAMP. So if you go to mamp.info, and there is a pro version of MAMP, but we don't need to use that. We can actually just use the free version. So if you click on Downloads, and then scroll down here, make sure Windows is selected. We've got MAMP and MAMP Pro for Windows, and then we click on Download. And then go ahead and let those files download. And then after it's downloaded, go ahead and run the installer. And after the installer's run, you should open up your MAMP window like this. And then it's set to automatically by default start your servers. So you'll know that the servers are up and running and ready to go when the Apache server light here is green and the MySQL server light here is green. If for some reason the servers don't start automatically, you can always push on the start server buttons. And it's always a good idea when you're done working on your website on your computer to click the stop server buttons before you close out of MAMP. And then what we want to do is we want to go to open the start page and make sure everything's working properly. Here we go. We now have a local server to run our website on. You can tell because we're here at localhost/MAMP, and we've got this MAMP webpage. Now, there's one bit of important information on the MAMP homepage, the MAMP start page here, and that is the database username and password, and those are both by default root, and we're going to need those passwords later on. So what I like to do first, while we've got this start page open up here, is head over to Tools, and then PHP MyAdmin, where we're going to set up a database for our website. WordPress requires a database, and that's what we're going to set up. So we click on either New here, or you can click on Databases over here, and you can create a database name here. Either way works. So for this, I'm just going to call it RWH-1, and that's going to be our database name. And then we're going to set the collation here to UTF general, and then click create. So we've got a confirmation that the database has been created, and then you can see the database file over here. So the next thing we need to do is download WordPress, and all you've got to do that is just head over to WordPress.org and then click on download WordPress either here, or usually the most recent version of WordPress has got a download button right here. So we'll go ahead and download that. And then after WordPress is downloaded, we want to open up the folder, and then we're going to open up this WordPress folder that's inside that zip file. And we've got all the files that we need here for WordPress. And we need to copy these files here over to the folder on our computer where our website is going to be. So to do that, the easiest way that I've found is to go back to your MAMP start window here, or your MAMP screen, and then you click on Preferences, and then Web Server, and this shows you where the files for your websites are going to be. It'll be at c/mamp/htdocs by default. And we can click on Open, and that'll open up the folder there. And then you could just drop everything right in here if you wanted to, but if you want to develop multiple websites on your computer, so if you're working on multiple websites at the same time, all you got to do is just create a new folder, and then each folder will be a website. So I'm going to call this RWH-1, and that's going to sort of serve as like the URL on your computer for your website that you're building. And then we just drag in our WordPress files here, or copy them over. Okay, so now we've got our files all copied over into our website folder that we're going to build this website on. So we can go ahead and close these folders here. And we can just actually close this. I find the easiest way to get back to that is just click back over here. You can just say cancel to this and then back and open the start page. Or you can just go to localhost/. And there we go. Now we've got this website folder that we've created for our website. And if you created multiple folders in there, they would all appear right here. And we can go ahead and click on the RWH-1. And it's going to take us right to the WordPress install. So we click continue. Now we can start installing WordPress. So now it's just asking us to make sure we have this information, which we already do, and that's the database name that we just created, the database username, which I showed you is root, and the database password, which is root, and the database host, which is localhost. So we can go ahead and install WordPress. So we'll click on Let's Go. Then we'll configure this information. So the database name that I created was rwh-1. You'll probably have your own unique name there for your database. Then the username for the database is root, and the password is root. And then the host is localhost. That's correct. And we'll click Submit. And then we'll just click Run the install. Okay, now it's asking us for a site title, so we'll go ahead and put a site title here. This would be the name of your site. I don't have a name since this is just a test, so I'll just put in test. And you want to create a username. You always want to make sure anything on the web, but especially for the back end of your website, that you don't make the username admin or something very basic and generic. The reason why is that unfortunately we live in a world where there are a ton of hackers out there. They've got computers that they've hacked that they use as bots, and they'll just go and they'll try every generic username and password to break into your website, and they'll try any sort of common name. So you really want to use a unique username for the main administrator on your website. And then you also, it's really important to use a unique password. Right here you can see that WordPress is actually encouraging you to use a unique password by generating one for you. I use LastPass to manage all of my passwords. I highly recommend that even if you're building just one website, that you use LastPass. That way you've got a unique password for every website and every account that you create. It's one great security measure that you can do, and it's fairly easy using either LastPass like I use, or there's other password programs like 1Pass. So I'm going to go ahead and use this recommended password here. I'm just going to copy it so that I can know what it is, and I'm going to copy it into my LastPass folder. And then put in your email, and this is where all of the notifications are going to go to about your website, so like your lost password if you lose your password, or information about your website such as comments and things like that. Right now it's not that important since it's on our local host, but it's just a good idea to put it in there so that when you do go live with your website, that information's in there. And even actually, if you do lose your password with the local host, it will actually be able to email you using this password even on your local computer. Now you can choose to discourage search engines from indexing the site. I usually like to do that when I'm developing a website. Here, since it's being developed on our local computer, it probably doesn't really matter that much. So you might want to either check it or uncheck it. Just make sure that when your website's ready to go and live and you put it on your live hosting server, that this is unchecked so that search engines are encouraged to index your site rather than being discouraged. And then we can go ahead and click on Install WordPress. And there we go. Now WordPress is installed and we can log in. And so we'll just enter in our username that we just created and that password. And now we're taken to the back end of our website, and we can go to the front end. And there we go. So that is how you install WordPress on your Windows computer. So if you're looking for how to move this website from your local host to a live server, I've got a video on how to do that, the easiest way that I have found. And if you're looking for a theme to use for WordPress or which hosting company to pick, check out my reviews on different hosting companies and themes. And if you've got any questions or comments, go ahead and leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching.
I'll post the written instructions for this video at realwebsitehints.com. I have the link here below. And for more tips and tricks and reviews that will help you make great websites easily, be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel and visit me at realwebsitehints.com. Thanks for watching.